Consumer good makers are grappling with the demand slowdown in the country. Many companies are looking to cut prices to drive volumes. But do the commodity costs leave any room for price cuts? Charlene D'Souza has looked at different raw materials to find out which FMCG players might be better placed. Charlene, interesting analysis. I'm looking forward to this. Tell us about it.
So while Indians have cut back on spending on various goods like biscuits and shampoos and things like that due to stagnant wage growth and also due to falling rural incomes, value growth of the sector has also grown at its lowest pace in the last 7 years. But what's coming to the relief at this point in time for soap makers and paint makers is lower commodity cost. While, for biscuit makers, commodity costs are on the rise. Now, the first commodity that we look at is PFAD, or palm fatty acid distillate. Now, this is extensively used in the making of soaps. Now, the price of the commodity has remained volatile over the last 12 months, but it is still lower compared to last year, because of which HUL has already resorted to price cuts and will resort to further price cuts in the personal care category. Now, the next commodity that we look at is titanium dioxide. While it's a key ingredient in the making of paints and has fallen by 5.4% over the last 1 year, the largest paints maker, that is Asian Paints, has only cut prices by 0.4% in the first quarter of this year and 0.4% in the September ended quarter. And this is obviously helping margins for the company, because they've seen volume growth also come in double digits in the quarter that just went by. Now, for a company like Britannia, wheat and sugar prices have been on an increase, and these are the two main ingredients that go into the making of a biscuit. Now, in order to hedge against the rising wheat prices, Britannia Industry in the first quarter bought wheat and stocked up on around 700 crores of wheat, and to hedge against rising wheat costs. Now, this, the company said then, that would fulfill their requirements for wheat till the third quarter, that is the ongoing quarter. Now, the next or the last commodity that we've looked at is copra, which is extensively used by Marico. While prices have been on an increase in the last 3 months, but it's still lower compared to what it was in February. But the company has not cut prices to that extent, and they've only offered some promotional offers during the period.
Yeah, I think copra prices, in a manner of speaking, were a large mover for Marico in the current quarter numbers as well, Charlene.
Yeah.
But I was intrigued by the first mention that you did about PFAD. Now, my question is HUL on record stating that they will go out and cut prices further as well? Because they have done some price tinkering already.
Yeah, they already have in their personal care category, and they've also said that going ahead in Dove and in Pears, that they would take further price cuts. They've already taken on their mass segment, that is your Lux and Lifebuoy. They've already initiated around a 4% price hike, 3 to 4%, and they'll take another 2% in this quarter, is what they've said after their second quarter earnings.
So price cuts coming from HUL side. Are other soap makers following suit as well because of the raw material prices being
high? We don't have a particular any indication on that as front, but usually once HUL takes a price cut, other companies
follow suit
because they're the largest soap makers and nobody wants to lose market share at this point in time.
Yeah, well, that's interesting. So maybe those benign prices help at least the soap makers take some price cuts as well. Let's see if there is some bit of volume pickup as a result of that. Charlene, thanks so much for putting that into perspective.